Hello everybody, my name's Peter Nash and I'm the leader of the children's ministry in the Potter's House Church of Norwich, and this here is Mr. Squid. And Mr. Squid and me have just been talking. Let me explain how we talk. When he goes to the top, he's saying no, and when he goes to the bottom, he's saying yes. And that means you can ask him some questions. So let me ask him some questions about children's church today. Mr. Squid, are we having children's church today? I believe that is a yes. Yes, we are having children's church today. But Mr. Squid, are we having it in our own building? I believe that's a no. And so no, we can't have it in our own building. But Mr. Squid, are we going to have it online? I believe we're going to have it online. That's right, we can't have it in our building. We're going to have children's church online. So why don't you join us right now for our praise and worship? No? No? Did you say no to praise and worship? Do you mean no? Of course he doesn't mean no. He means yes. Let's have some praise and worship. Amen.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Every day, every day, every day, in every way, I'm gonna let my little light shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Every day, every day, every day, in every way, I'm gonna let my little light shine.
Just what to say
on a Thursday.
He taught me just how to pray
on a Friday.
He gave me a little more faith
on a Saturday.
He gave me a lot more grace
on a Sunday.
He gave me the power divine
to let my new light shine.
Every day,
every day, every day,
Bye.
praise and worship, everybody. Right now it's time to pray. There are lots of things we could be praying for in this time, but let's pray for the children's churches in this country, because everybody's doing children's church online, or most of them anyway. And so let's pray for those people involved in that, that they do the best and God does the rest. Let's pray for our government to make right decisions about going back to school or going back to work for some of you. Let's pray that those decisions are right and they come at the right time. Let's pray for us to have a right heart, the children, the parents, everybody, all those that believe in Jesus, to have a right heart in this time and to behave in a way that is honorable to God. Let's pray for those things in Jesus' name. Every head bowed, every eye closed, let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you, Lord God, for the privilege of serving you, Lord God, and we give you the glory, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, for Children's Church. We pray for the children's churches in this land, Lord God, for everybody involved in that, Lord God. Help them, Lord God, to get over their fear of technology, Lord God. Help them to do their best, Lord God, we pray. In Jesus' name, we pray for the government, Lord God. Give Boris Johnson clear understanding of the way forward, Lord. Help the government, Lord God, to make right decisions regards work, Lord God, and school and what is happening to this country, Lord God. I pray in Jesus' name that, Lord God, you, Lord God, will help us, Lord God, each and every one of us, Lord God, to have a good heart in this time. In Jesus' name we pray. And all the children said, amen. That means it's now time for Children's Church. And welcome to Children's Church. Me and Mr. Squid here have been having a great conversation. Today is about obedience. Is that what we said, Mr. Squid? I believe the answer is yes. And so, because we haven't got any children in the house, I believe we decided to use the dogs. Is that what we said, Mr. Squid? That is definitely a yes. And so we're going to use the dogs to show you what obedience is and what obedience isn't. Take a look at this.
Hi kids, me and Sheila are going to have a bit of a competition with our dogs, because we're going to see how obedient they are. One of them we know is not that obedient, but the other one does listen. And so I want you to decide for yourself, and I want you to figure out which one's good and which one's bad. Sheila will go first, and then I'll go second. My dog is AG. And Sheila's dog is Happy. And so, let's go to the next scene. Let's go to Happy and Sheila and see how they get on.
Happy, sit. Sit. Good girly. Happy, fetch. Fetch. Good girl. Good girl. Happy, come. Happy, sit. Good girl.
Edgy, come. Edgy, come. Edgy, come.
My dog doesn't always do what it's told.
Edgy, come. 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 Edgy. Edgy, come. Sit. Edgy, come. Sit. 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 Edgy, come. Good boy. Sit. Sit. Sit, sit. Edgy, come. Sit. Sit. Oh, come here. Come here. Edgy, come. Sit. Sit. Good boy. Edgy, fetch. That wasn't too bad. Come on. Come on. Fetch. Oh, fetch. Fetch. Oh, fetch. Boy. Edgy, come. Edgy, come. Edgy, come. Edgy, come. Edgy, come. Come. Sit.
Most of you can see which dog was well behaved and which dog was not. And hopefully, when people look at you, they don't see you behaving like the dog that was naughty. the dog that doesn't listen. But we're not here to talk about dogs. We're here to talk about God's word, and we're here to talk about obedience. So have a look at the memory verse.
Hi everybody, my name is Billy Blues, and I need you right now to help me with the memory verse. So what I need you to do is stand up, and if you want to help me with a memory verse, put your thumbs out like this. Hey, good, I can see those that are obedient and those that are not. That's funny, because that is what the memory verse is about. So, we're really going to rock it up. I want you to copy the things I do. Let's have some music, shall we? It goes like this. Whoa, that's really rock. So, I want you to begin by taking one hand and just going like this. And then I want you to take the other hand and go against it, like this. Come on, you can do this. Now, if I'm feeling foolish, so are you. But what is there to lose? The memory verse today is found in Ephesians 6:1. And it goes like this. Are you ready? Obey your parents in the Lord, obey your parents in the Lord, obey your parents in the Lord, obey your parents in the Lord. Your parents in the Lord, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right, for this is right. Obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right, for this is right. When all said and done, in Ephesians 6:1, it's really there to help you, not to stop you having something. Obey your parents in the Lord, your parents in the Lord, obey your parents in the Lord, obey your parents in the Lord, obey your parents in the Lord. Because this is right. Let's play the air guitar. Obey your parents in the Lord. Obey your parents. Obey your parents in the Lord. Obey your parents. Let's play the air drums. Obey your parents in the Lord. Obey your parents in the Lord. Parents in the Lord. Obey your parents in the Lord. Because this is right. When all is said and done in Ephesians 6:1, this is here to help you, not to stop you having fun. Obey your parents in the Lord. Your parents in the Lord. Obey your parents in the Lord. Come on, join in. Obey your parents in the Lord. Yeah, because this is right. Ephesians 6:1. Ephesians 6:1. Ephesians 6:1. Ephesians 6:1. Ephesians 6:1. Ooh. Ephesians 6:1. Come on, come on. Ephesians 6:1. Ephesians 6:1. Ephesians 6:1. When all is said and done, have some fun. This scripture's to help you, not to stop you having fun. Ephesians 6:1. Ephesians 6:1. Obey your parents in the Lord. Obey your parents in. Obey your parents in the Lord. For this is right. I wish I had time to play this, but I haven't. But I need you to say these words. Ephesians 6:1. Obey your parents in the Lord. Because this is right. One more time. Obey your parents in the Lord. Your parents in the Lord. Your parents in the Lord. Obey your parents in the Lord. Ephesians 6:1. Ephesians 6:1. Oh, Ephesians 6:1. Ephesians 6:1. Obey your parents in the Lord. Because this is right. Thank you for listening.
So that was the memory verse, Ephesians 6:1, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for that is right. At this moment in time, most of the children in this country have to stay at home. And that means your parents are probably telling you to do things more and more than they normally would, because you're spending more time with them. And so that puts you in a place where you have to make a decision. Do I listen or do I not? The truth is, you don't have to make a decision, because if you're obedient to God's word, when it especially says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right, because that's a clear instruction, an easy instruction to follow. Obey your parents. Now, be honest with me. Even though God's instruction is clear about obeying your parents, who struggles with that? I know I did. Have you ever wondered why? Have you ever considered why that may be? Take a look at this. Maybe that'll help.
Stories of the Bible. Adam and Eve sin. This is Adam.
Hey.
And this is Eve.
Hi.
Who were the first people on earth. They lived in the Garden of Eden, which was a beautiful place that had everything they needed. Adam and Eve took care of the animals and could eat from any of the trees in the garden, except for one. This was the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, and God told them not to eat from this tree. There were lots of animals in the garden, but the serpent was the most clever of all the wild animals God had made. One day, he asked the woman,
"Hey, Eve,
did God really say you must not eat the fruit from any of these trees in the garden?"
No.
Eve said that they were able to eat from all of the fruit trees except the fruit from the tree in the middle of the garden. For God said, "You must not eat or even touch it. If you do, you will die."
No, that can't be.
"You won't die," said the serpent. "God knows that as soon as you eat it, you will be like God, knowing both good and evil." The woman was convinced. She saw that the tree was beautiful and its fruit looked delicious, and she wanted the wisdom it would give her. So she took some of the fruit and ate it. Then she gave some to Adam, and he ate it too. At that moment, their eyes were opened.
Oh no!
And they suddenly realized they weren't wearing clothes and were embarrassed. So they sewed fig leaves together to cover themselves. When the cool evening breezes were blowing, Adam and Eve heard God walking about in the garden.
Hide!
So they hid from God among the trees. Then God called to Adam, "Where are you?" Adam said, "I heard you walking in the garden, so I hid. I was afraid because I was naked." "Who told you that you were naked?" God asked. "Did you eat from the tree I told you not to eat from?" Adam said, "It was the woman you gave me who gave me the fruit, and I ate it." Then God asked Eve, "What have you done?" "The serpent tricked me," she replied. "That's why I ate it." Then God punished the serpent by making it so he would crawl on his belly from then on. He told Eve that she would have great pain in her life. Then God said to Adam that because he listened to Eve and did not obey what God had told him to do, his life would be very difficult. He would have to work hard to get food to eat, God said, "For you were made from dust, and to dust you will return." Then God made them clothing from the animals. But God knew that Adam and Eve could no longer live in the garden because of their sin. So he sent them away and closed up the garden.
So that means, from the beginning of time, it has been in us to have a sinful nature that causes us to do things wrong, even when we know it's right. And that's why we need rules. That's why we need parents. That's why we need God to help us do things right. Because they're all there to bring instruction. And without instruction, we don't know what we need to be doing.
"I don't need instruction. I don't need instruction,"
some of you say. The truth is, we do need instruction. I spoke to a friend of mine, and she is a professor, and she told me there's an experiment you can do. Why don't I let her explain? Watch this experiment. It's good.
Hello there, welcome to my laboratory. Forgive the noise in the background, that's my extractor fan. I just done a very smelly experiment. So, why are you here with me? Well, the thing is, so Mr. Peters asked me to come up with an experiment for you children, you little peeps out there, that you will do this experiment to see how you follow the instructions. To follow instructions, you must be doing the listenings as well. And I know what your little peeps are like. So I have sent Mr. Peets the special test for you to do. Let's have a look at this and see how you've been getting along.
Good morning, boys. How are you?
Good.
Good, glad to hear it. Right, Pete Nash has given us a challenge to do for Children's Church, okay? So I've got here a picture of a piece of paper folded in a certain way. There you go. Now we have to copy this piece of paper exactly as Pete's done. So we have one piece of paper to use and also some scissors, okay? So we've got a piece of paper and some scissors and we've got 4 minutes starting now. How do you think you're going to do it? It's got to be exactly the same.
Cut here, slice it there. Cut here, slice it there, and then fold it.
Well, I don't know, try it then.
It looks like that. Hey!
Be careful, we've only got one piece of paper. Right, what do you reckon, Joshy? We're nearly there, got 30 seconds. I think you've got really good to get this far, but I just somehow Pete gets it to stand up pristinely, doesn't he? Go on then, give us your best effort. Can we see it? Can we have a close up? Can you put it in the middle of the table for us? Well, that's not bad, but I think there might be something missing. What do we say? What do we say? What do you reckon to Pete? Message to Pete?
I thought it was easy, but actually it was hard.
Ooh, right. What do you think, Noah?
Good.
Yeah, good. All right. There you go, Pete.
Ah, Joshua. Very good try. But you did not have any instructions. That is the problem. When we try to do things on our own, without any instructions, we get ourselves in a pickle. Now, I will hand over Mr. Peets to give Joshua the instructions. Let's see what happens next.
Paper, I'm going to do it for you, and I'll show you the bit that you didn't quite understand. You have to make two cuts on one side towards the middle.
Good to see you all here in the video.
See you guys, thank you so much.
Right, Josh, do you want to give it a go? Noah? Can you remember? Or do you want to watch it again? Super smashing great. Do you want to show the camera? That's it. Oh, that's it. Oh, that's it. There we go. Well done. Well done, nannies. What do you say, boys?
Thank you, babe.
See you later.
Joshua and Noah, excellent job. Very good. It just goes to show that when we follow the instructions, we can complete the tasks. Remember, children, ask for help if you do not know. Sometimes the adults do know the answers. Bye for now.
Well done, Professor Bunsenbrenner, and well done, boys, because that is the proof we need to show us you do need instructions. And that is one of the jobs of our parents, to give us instructions, to help us not to make mistakes. You could see Josh, like, looking and thinking, trying to figure out how to do without instruction, and he did it wrong. And yet, when he had clear instructions, he did it right. But there must be other reasons why we need to obey our parents. And so take a look at this.
Hey guys, it's me again, Douglas. And do you want to know something about me? I love cookies. Okay, not just cookies, but chocolate chip cookies. And not just chocolate chip cookies. My mom's chocolate chip cookies. They are so good. And when she bakes them, I can smell them all the way up here in my womb. And it just, oh man, it smells so good. And they taste even better than that. And one day I was sitting up here and I could smell that great smell of chocolate chip cookies. And so I ran down the stairs and sure enough, my mom was making some chocolate chip cookies, and I could see them cooking in the oven, and they were all sizzling, and they smelled so good, and so my mom got them out of the oven. She put them on the tray, and you can't eat them yet because they're too hot. If you touch them, you'll get burnt. So we had to wait for them to cool off, and then my mom put them into the cookie jar. And at our house, we have this cookie jar that looks like a cow. And when you open up its head, you get the cookies. It goes, meh. And so my mom put the cookies in the cookie jar. And I went up to her and I said, okay, Mom, can I have some cookies? And she said, yep, you may have two cookies. And so I said, thanks, Mom. So I just took the two cookies in each hand. And I just went, nom, 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 and I munched them up really, really fast. I ate them really, really quick. And I said, okay, Mom, I'd like some more cookies. And she said, nope, no more cookies until after dinner, otherwise you'll get sick. That didn't make me very happy, because I wanted those cookies. I mean, it doesn't make any sense. If they taste good, I should just eat as many as I want, right? So my mom went into the other room, and she had to make a phone call. And so I knew right then and there that I had to come up with the most brilliant plan to get those cookies. And so what I did was, well, see, here's the problem with the cookies is they were up in the cookie jar, way up on the counter, and I'm not very tall. I'm kind of short, vertically challenged, and so I can't just reach up there and grab them. So I thought maybe if I got a broom, I could knock it down. So I got the biggest broom that we had, but it was really big and heavy, and so I was trying to, you know, walk around with this big giant broom, and I was gonna knock it down, but it was just too big. I couldn't control it, and I finally just fell right down. Oof. And so that didn't work very well at all. So I had to come up with a better plan, and I did. I had the greatest idea because last year, for my birthday, I got this awesome bow and arrow set, but not the kind of bow and arrow that's like pokey or hurts people. It's the kind with the suction cup on the end, you know, the kind that go when it sticks to things. And yeah, so I took a rope and I tied it all up around the arrow, and I went into the kitchen and I pulled, and then twang, it stuck. Right on the very first try, I got the cow right on the first try. I was so proud of myself. I was like Master Archer or something. And so I pulled on the rope, and and the cookie jar fell down on the ground, and it kind of broke into, you know, several pieces. But I grabbed all the cookies and I put them into my short, and the cow cookie jar was just laying there like, and so I thought, that's no good. My mom will find out right away. So I tried to, you know, fix it, but it was still broken, just lying there mooing at me. So I shoved it all under the rug, hoping my mom wouldn't notice, but it's still, you could kind of hear it. It was just like, but I thought, you know, maybe she wouldn't tell. So I grabbed the cookies and I sneak all the way up to my room, and I closed the door and I sat down on the bed and I started to eat all those cookies. Okay, there were like 47 cookies. And so I started eating and I got kind of full after like two more cookies, but I had to eat all of them because then I didn't want my mom to find them. So I just kept eating and oh man. You have no idea how sick I felt after eating all those cookies, and my tummy was like this big. It felt awful. And so I just laid down on the bed and I just felt so bad. And then I heard the most terrifying sound in the whole wide world. And it sounded like this. It was like step, step, step. It was my mom. She was coming up the stairs. She was coming to my room. So I got under the covers and I threw the pillow on my tummy because I thought maybe she wouldn't notice. My tummy was so huge if I had the pillow on it. And I brushed the crumbs off under the bed. And she came in and she said, Douglas, your friends are outside. They'd like to play soccer with you. And, okay, I love cookies, all right, a lot. But I also love to play soccer. I like to be the goalie. I catch the ball so the other team doesn't make a goal. And yeah, I'm pretty good at it. I love to play with my friends anytime they can. But you know, I couldn't go today because my tummy was this big and I felt awful. So I said, I don't think I want to go and play today, Mom. That's okay. And she was like, well, Douglas, why don't you want to go play outside with your friends? You love to play soccer. And I wanted to lie, but then I remembered that moms have like this superpower where they always know when you're lying. So I had to tell the truth. So I just said, I can't go play soccer because I feel awful. I ate all the cookies and look, my tummy is this big. And she was like, well, Douglas, I told you not to eat those cookies. I told you it'd make you sick. And I was like, I know, but they were so good. I wanted to eat all of them. And she said, Douglas, I didn't just tell you not to eat those cookies because I wanted to ruin your day. It's because I love you and I knew it would make you sick. I don't want you to be sick. You know, sometimes it's like that with us and God. See, in the Bible, God tells us some things we should and should not do. You know, like he says not to lie, and he says not to steal, and things like that. And we think sometimes that, you know, maybe God doesn't really know what he's talking about, and I'm just going to do this anyways. But God doesn't just make up these rules because he likes to ruin our fun. He doesn't just, you know, he doesn't give us these rules because he likes to be bossy. He does it because he loves us so very much. And he knows what's best for us. He knows that if we do these bad things that he doesn't want us to do, that it's going to be bad for us. And it's going to be bad for other people too. And so that's kind of what I learned, is that we need to obey God and our parents because they love us and they know what's best for us. Well, I'll see you guys later. And next time you don't want to obey your parents or God, don't forget that they love you very, very much, and they know what's best. Bye!
And so the other reason why we need to obey God and our parents is because they love us very much. But there's another reason why we should be obedient to our parents. And that is, if we can learn to be obedient to our parents, we can learn to obey other people that God has put in charge of us.
Teacher.
Nursery teacher.
Police officer.
Lifeguard.
Doctor.
Nurses at the hospital.
Shopkeepers.
The Prime Minister.
Your lollipop lady.
Or the dinner lady. Or a firefighter.
Or your school football coach.
Your grandparents.
Your parents when they tell you off and when they read to you.
These are all authority figures. Can you think of any more people in authority in your life?
In the Bible, it says in Romans 13:1, let every person be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and those that exist have been instituted by God. That means God's put those people in charge. God's put those people in a place where they can tell us what to do. And so we have to listen to them because it's the right thing to do. God has given us parents and a whole lot of other people we should listen to. And if we struggle to listen to their instructions, how are we going to listen to God? James 1:22 says, do not be merely listeners to the word, and so deceiving yourself, do what it says. That means this: when God is telling you to do something through the reading of his word, through the preaching of his word, or even if God is telling you to do something in some other way, you need to be obedient to it. You need to listen to the voice of God and do as he's saying. Take a look at this.
Samuel. Hannah prays for a baby. God answers her prayers and gives her a baby boy named Samuel. When Samuel is old enough, he goes to live in God's temple. Samuel helps the high priest Eli. Samuel wears a special linen vest that the priests wear. He is a good boy and works hard. One night, when Samuel is sleeping, he hears someone call his name. Samuel runs to Eli. Here I am. You called me? Samuel says. Eli yawns and shakes his head. No, I didn't call you. Go back to bed. Samuel hears someone call his name again. He runs to Eli, but the priest sends him back to bed. Then Samuel hears someone call him a third time. So he runs and wakes up Eli once more. Here I am. You called me? Samuel says. Eli knows that God is calling Samuel. He tells Samuel, if you are called again, say, speak, Lord, your servant is listening. God calls Samuel again. Speak, Lord, your servant is listening, says Samuel. God answers. This time, Samuel listens and hears an important message from God. When he grows up, Samuel becomes a great prophet and leader. And he still listens to God.
And hopefully, if you can learn to be obedient to your parents and obedient to others that God has put in charge, then that will help you to be obedient to God himself. In John 11:28, it says this, but he said, more than blessed are those who hear the word of God and keep it. you can keep obeying the word of God, that is exactly what will happen. But what happens when you don't obey the word of God? Wants to be obey the word of God. What happens when we don't obey the word of God? Well, people with attitudes like that, take a look at this.
Stories of the Bible, the parable of the two builders. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like walking on water.
Oh, hey guys.
And even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
One day, as he saw the crowds gathering, Jesus went up to the mountainside and sat down. His disciples gathered around him, and he began to teach them. He asked them, "Why do you keep calling me Lord, Lord, when you don't do what I say?" Anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise.
Hey, I'm gonna build here.
Yeah, I'm gonna build out there.
All right, suit yourself.
Like a person who builds a house on solid rock.
Oh, yeah.
When the floodwaters rise and break against that house, it stands firm because it was well built.
I'm in here.
But anyone who hears my teaching and doesn't obey it is foolish.
All right, hey, it's nice.
Like a person who builds a house on sand.
Uh-oh.
When the rains and floods come and the winds beat against that house, it will collapse with a mighty crash. When Jesus had finished saying these things, the crowds were amazed at his teaching.
Of course, the crowds were amazed at the teachings of Jesus because Jesus taught the truth. And if you can be obedient to that truth, if you can be obedient to your parents, if you can be obedient to others that God has put in place, it will help you to build your life on the rock, on the foundations that God has put in place. It will be a great start to your life and will help you in the future because your life will be built on God's word. Every head bowed and every eye closed. The foolish build their house on the sand, but we build a house on the rock. Jesus himself was obedient to his Father, was obedient right up into the cross, where he was willing to give his life for us. He died on a cross for our sin. He died on a cross for that nature that makes us do things wrong. But that is a great thing, because he rose from the dead and he did that to save us. Jesus is alive and he wants us to have relationship with him. And so right now, I'm going to lead you through a prayer. If you want Jesus in your life, if you want to start being obedient, because what a great place to start being obedient, asking Jesus into your life. If you want Jesus to save you, then say these words after me. Lord Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner. That I know that you died on the cross for my sins. And I ask you to forgive me. And I ask you to save me. And I promise to be obedient to your word and to follow you. Help me to make it to heaven and save me in Jesus' name. Amen. And so, children, remember. Remember, obedience is a great thing. And even though we're at home with our parents right now, even though we're spending more time around people telling us what to do, let's come under that. Let's listen to that. And one last thing, as always, stay safe, stay saved, and stay serving. Amen.